And this movie, I felt like brought a.
It happened.
It did. It did.
Hey, just keep it on the.
Yeah, okay, that's fine. Pizza. How's it going, Movie Maniacs? I'm Zach.
And I'm Matt.
And this is the previews. Welcome back to the everyone's favorite part of the movie.
Exactly. It's been a while.
It's been a minute. It's been a minute.
It definitely has been. We do apologize. Just, you know, life happens and...
Holidays. This guy got sick for like a week.
Yep. You get sick. I bought the house.
Nah, I'm about to start a new job.
Exactly. Yeah. Woo! It's getting tough to see movies, but I think we're back on track now.
Yeah.
I'm all moved in. I'm feeling better.
Mm-hmm.
Your job is about to, you know, begin, but we kind of worked out the kinks there.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
But to really kick off the new year with both of us being here, we decided to play catch up a little bit for 2019 and go see
1917.
Yes, we did. Directed by Sam Mendes. I'm going to say cinematographer, which we don't give a shout out to a lot, is Roger Deakins.
Good call on that.
Yep, and then starring George McKay and Dean Charles Chapman, which many of you may know as Tommen.
Tommen from Game of Thrones.
Yes. Yep. Exactly. So, kicking off the year 2020, this movie has obviously won numerous awards. Do you think they're warranted, yes or no?
I do. For me saying that, am I saying this is my favorite movie of the year? No, but this movie had a lot to enjoy.
Yes,
yeah.
I could not agree anymore.
Acting and the set pieces, directing, and just like you said, giving a shout out to the cinematographer.
Yeah, Roger Deakins. Hey, wow. I mean, he's a shoo-in for all the cinematography awards.
Yep.
Like, it's not even close. Like, I know a lot of people might say Word Got Out, it's a one-shot movie, and some people that I know on the YouTube community said, well, you know, it could be a little bit gimmicky. It's not. It is not a gimmick. Like, you feel it. You definitely feel it.
Yeah, because I don't know if many maniacs know, because a big draw to this movie was it was said to be all in one shot.
Yeah.
Yes, which it definitely felt like. I mean, but at least me knowing the way movies are shot, I definitely seen the way they were able
transition.
To. Yeah, I was able to see how they were managed to maybe to not make it all one shot, but it still definitely felt like it, and it added so much to the movie.
Yeah, it's very convincing. The one shot really adds another depth.
Exactly. 12 miles on paper might not sound that long, but for it all being one shot, you really see how far that distance is.
Yeah, you really do, and you see all like the little things, them go falling in trenches, pulling themselves out, you know, running around like rats.
Rats in dead bodies.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The whole nine. Mm-hmm. The whole nine, and they really do a convincing job. And really, how I like to grade war movies, granted, I've never been to war.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had a relative that had gone into war.
Mm-hmm.
My best friend's father was a colonel in the army.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I hear some stories here and there, especially what I look for in war movies is I want to see a dark, gritty take on war.
Mm-hmm.
Something that I can believe, like I'm transported back to the battlefield, not the movies like American Sniper, where it's like, oh, I'm G.I. Joe, I'm going in there to take out the terrorists, let's do it. I want to see people scared. I want to see people fighting for their lives. That's what I want to see. Now, granted, I don't have any personal background in war, nor do I ever plan on it. But, you know, I just want to say God bless them.
Oh, you mean World War III with Iran, dude? What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, whoa.
Yeah, man, all that modern warfare you're playing, dude. What do you mean? You're ready.
Oh, I'm not ready. My KD on that game, now if they went off the KD in Black Ops 4, I'd be drafted right now. I'm the colonel. Look at me. I'm the captain now. But yeah, Modern Warfare, hell no. Hell no. But I like the take that they took, because I felt like I was transported there, and that one shot again really brought me there.
Mm-hmm.
We're huge advocates for it. Go see it in Dolby for sure.
Oh yeah, yeah, Dolby, because when these shots are fire and the explosions happen, like,
you feel
like you're there. You know, it's just these two guys walking through this battlegrounds, and there's maybe 20 minutes, 25 minutes of nothing. Them just walking over bodies and going through these trenches and all that, and just bam, and then you're right there with them.
Yeah,
and then just with the seats vibrating, just added that extra attention.
You got to give credit to the actors, right? Mm-hmm. George MacKay and Dean Charles Chapman. Mm-hmm. Okay, George MacKay, this kid's a star in the making. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you right now. He's got it all. He's got the emotion in his face. Mm-hmm. He's a man of few words. You could see mm-hmm. pretty much everything that's going on, you know, with mm-hmm. most of his facial expressions. I'm mm-hmm. telling you right now, Kevin Feige, I know you don't watch the show. Kevin Feige, you cast this man as Cyclops in the new X-Men. That chin and the way he could emote with his eyebrows, I mean, he's a good-looking man. He's uh-huh. good, he needs to be Cyclops, okay?
That's interesting. Yeah, I can kind of see that.
Yeah, he did it. And then the guy who played Tommen, he did great, too. Nothing taken away from him. So, Zach, I know you were a huge Once Upon a Time in Hollywood fan, mm-hmm. okay? And really, right now, it's a neck-and-neck race between Sam Mendes with directing 1917 versus Quentin Tarantino with Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. I'm going to put you on the spot here, okay? I'm going to put you right on the spot. Coming out of 1917, who do you think deserves the best director nom?
Dude, this is really putting me on the spot, man.
Yeah, uh-huh.
We're talking about Quentin Tarantino here, and... Yep. And I mean, they both did an amazing job for what they were trying to do. Mm-hmm. Sam Mendes was trying to bring the war, making you feel like you're there in war.
Yes.
And again, this him pulling the single shot really pulled that. And then Quentin Tarantino trying to bring you back in the '60s, bringing with the bright lights and the old cars and just because I always say I feel like I've grown up in the wrong era, but just because life was so simple,
yeah.
bringing that simplicity back then,
mm-hmm.
and oh man, I still think I have to give it to Quentin Tarantino. I'm sorry.
Okay. Now I'm not gonna let's put it this way. I'm not gonna not disagree with you, right?
Uh-huh.
Like I think they're both worthy, you know, nominations for Best Director. Mm-hmm. Personally, for me, I might do Sam Mendes, because mm-hmm. I didn't like Once Upon a Time in Hollywood that much. I mean, mm-hmm. I liked it. I didn't love it, which mm-hmm. I was expecting to. I feel with Sam Mendes, at least, the creativity with doing the one shot and the story that he brought forth with this tale, I think I would have to give it to him, but that's just based off of pure creativity.
I get it.
Yeah, I don't think you can argue it because he did a good job, and you know, Sam Mendes really coming from a background of like action movies, you mm-hmm. know, him pulling off this, because let's put it this way too, for you movie maniacs who are going in there expecting like an action-packed movie, go see Bad Boys for Life. This is a slow,
yeah, very slow
journey
movie.
Where at the end of the movie, just, when the credits rolled, I felt exhausted.
Yeah. Well, just like I said, there's 20 minutes of like them just literally walking
and
going through these trenches.
But it's enjoyable.
Something I can't believe we forgot to give praise to till this point was the score and music mm-hmm. of this movie.
Yep, which is by Thomas Newman.
Yeah.
Which, woo!
Yeah, the G's did it build up the tension.
I felt so like anxious.
Yeah, very on edge.
Very, very on edge. Like I felt like I couldn't. I guess the last time I felt this way was when I saw A Quiet Place the first time, mm-hmm. where I felt like I couldn't eat the popcorn or I couldn't, like, you know, sip on my pop because I thought I was going to make a noise because uh-huh. I was, like, that on edge of my seat. But honestly, in this movie, it stressed me out. Like, I was stress eating my popcorn during it. I was full. I was like, I don't need any more popcorn. I kept shoveling that stuff in because I was like, oh, man, I feel anxious right now. So, overall, 1917, your first review of 2020, what are you giving it?
I'm going to go 4 Bastard Rats out of 5.
Okay. I'm going to go, because of the creativity, I'm going to give it a little bit more than you. I'm going to go ahead and give it 4.5 Spoiled Breads out of 5.
Okay, nice.
Yep. So that's it for this week, Movie Maniacs. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, hit that bell icon so you get notified of every single review we upload. And then next week, we will see you on, of course, the previews.